はい、クレイです。
Here we
go. Sorry.
何クレイです。
I have to say it in English. This is Clay. Hi, I'm Clay.
Yumi desu. Konnichiwa.
Today we want to talk about haiku. And haiku といえば
松尾芭蕉でしょう。芭蕉でしょう。一番有名、日本では一番有名な人です。
芭蕉でしょう。
芭蕉でしょう。
It rhymes. ちょっと。And the most famous 芭蕉 haiku, which you're probably already familiar with, is...
古池や川ず飛び込む水の音。
So, sometimes it may be translated as an ancient pond, a frog jumps in, the sound of water. So, what does it mean? Let's break it down. What's the first line?
古池の意味わかりますか?
An old pond or ancient pond.
そう。古い池。
Mm-hmm. But it's 古池。
川ずは、
It's an old-fashioned word for kaeru, for frog.
Kaeru, 飛び込むは?
So wait, so today you don't say kawazu, right? It's an archaic word.
Ah, kaeru ne, kaeru.
Kaeru, so they say kaeru, not kawazu.
今は kaeru.
Okay, and?
飛び込む.
Okay, so that's like a compound word. It has two verbs put together. Tobu, komu, tobi komu. So, tobu means to fly, or in this case, to jump. But Superman can tobu, right?
yeah.
But a frog doesn't fly, it jumps. And komu is used for showing going into or...
So, 中に入るってこと。
Yeah, coming into. So, he's jumping into the 古池, the old pond.
Okay. 水の音。
And then we have the sound of silence. No, sound of water.
The
sound of water. Oh.So let's listen to it one more time with Yumi, and maybe you can maybe say it slowly at first, let them say after you, and then say it normal speed.
古池や川ず飛び込む水の音。古池や川ず飛び込む水の音。
Now there's one word we did not mention. It is?
や。
や。What is ya?
古池や
Okay, it really doesn't have a meaning. It's called a kireji, right?
Kireji.
Which literally means cutting word. Anyway, so what does ya mean here? If it doesn't mean anything, what does it mean? Why is it there?
なんていうのかな古池をちょっと強調するために言う古池やって言うと古池を頭の中に思い浮かべるでしょ
So when you can think about, it gives you a pause, a moment to stop and think about this ancient pond.
ちょっと余韻ができるっていうのかな。
A resonance that lasts. You know, you can imagine and paint the picture in your head, 古池. And so you were saying earlier, if you say 古池に。
そうそう。古池に川ず飛び込む水の音って言ったら、ちょっと普通にただそれを説明してるだけ。
So it's just describing the situation. If you said it like, you know, with ni, to, you know, which would be fine grammar wise. But adding the ya is more like a rest or a pause.
Pause.
Stop and think, imagine this ancient pond, and then you see the frog.
そう、川ず飛び込む水の音だから、こう古い池があって、そこでちょっと考えて、そしてカエルが飛び込んで、ポチャンっていう音が響いてる感じがするでしょ。
So maybe there's maybe 芭蕉was trying to get people to think about the before, the silence before, and the silence after. This ancient pond.
そう。静かな感じ。
Frog jumps in.
そう。
Sound of water, and then sound of silence. Simon and Garfunkel.
すごくシンプルだけど。
But that's haiku. Haiku is very simple but very deep.
そう。